Today we're going to build a deck using Hebel PowerFloor. Now why we use Hebel PowerFloor is some great reasons. It's great insulation, it's fire resistant, termite proof, it goes together really easily, it gives you the same feel as a concrete slab. Plus after you waterproof it, it's ready to go for tiling. Over here we've got our subfloor. As you can see, we're anchored to the wall, we're on post shoes, noggins are in, we're ready to go. Now as you can see, you've got a few little corners to check around, here and here. So I've marked it out on the Hebel panel, and it's as easy as using a cheap handsaw. Cuts through the Hebel beautifully. When you've got a long deck, you want to get a nice straight line. So what I've done, I've actually used a string line, measured off the thickness of the panel, which is 600 millimeters, run the string line right through to the end, and that'll actually set you up for the rest of the panels. After that's done, you're ready for glue. Just use a construction adhesive, a maxi bond or a liquid nails, and make sure you put in about a 5mm bead. That's what you want. Make sure you follow the string line, get your first run done perfectly, and then you're ready to go. Now we're ready to screw off the first panel. When you're screwing down the panels, they're about 75mm thick. You gotta go into the joist, use 100mm hex head screws, 14 gauge. Make sure you screw no less than 50mm from the ends. And you want to countersink them at least 10 to 15mm. The great thing about Hebel is when you screw it in, you don't have to pre-drill. When it comes to gluing your Hebel panels together, you want to use Hebel adhesive. Now it's a simple process. You throw some into a bucket, you mix it up with some water. You can use a stirrer or you can actually buy an attachment for your cordless drill. You want to pretty much stir it until you get a consistency of runny porridge. Then that is perfect, ready for gluing. When it comes to joining the sheets, the panels need to have a good solid amount of adhesive on each panel. So it's pretty much just getting it onto a trowel, throwing a nice thick amount on. Very important that when you put the two panels together, you want to see it squeeze through the top of the joint. Then you know you've got good adhesion between the two panels. Remembering the first run, you line it up with your string line. Anything on the top, just scrape it back and you're ready to go for the next one. Okay, the next stage is actually cutting your Hebel to create your stretch bond pattern when you're creating your deck. Great little tip. Use an aluminium guide or a bit of timber or whatever you have. Measure the distance from your blade to the outside of the saw. Now, we're going to actually screw this down to the Hebel panel. That'll actually give me a perfect straight guide to run the saw straight across the Hebel and give me an accurate cut. Very important and very easy to do. The blade's usually set not to the full depth of the panel. You need to cut through most of the panel and through the reinforcement. Then it's as simple as breaking the rest of it out and you're ready to go to install. Once you've cut the panels of the PowerFloor, as you can see, you're probably going to expose some of the steel reinforcement. Now it's very important to just give it a quick wipe down and use the anti-corrosion protection paint. Dab it on the ends, it won't create any concrete cancer throughout your Hebel, much the same as like a concrete slab. Just got to remember that every joint needs your Hebel adhesive to actually create that whole one section as a strong hold. You need all your joints just on one side to fill in the end. So when you throw your next PowerFloor panel against this one, it'll actually adhere to the next one. Creates a beautiful, strong surface. Remember, the next panel is actually shorter than the last, so that'll actually create the stretcher bond pattern. Push it into the other side. Fix it off. Make sure it squeezes through the joint. Thank you. All right, just glued the joist. Got the adhesive on the last row of panels. We're ready to install the last row, and then this decking area is going to be almost complete. How easy was that? Now the Hebel PowerFloor is down, you've just created a solid base. Now you can get a good quality waterproofing installed and then pick a tile and just go for it. Check this out, the deck is done. The tiles have been laid and it looks awesome. Now what you've got to do is sit back and see what else you can build out of Hebel, the better way to build.